Well, let's kind of need this after all. Midnight in Paris. Okay, before I start this review, I have to give out two very special shoutouts that I shamefully neglected to give out during my epic shoutout video. And I'm gonna make it quick because I know it can get boring, and as a good friend once told me, it's just another way for YouTubers to blow each other. And that's actually quite funny. The first shoutout goes to Lee, aka Bright Eyes Long Lashes, the definitive female critic from the UK. I love watching her reviews because it always seems like she's gonna complain about something, but she always brings up a good point. And the second shout out goes to a girl who has truly stolen mi corazón, and that's Bamboo Productions. I'm not even gonna begin to attempt to tell you how much I adore this woman because it would just take up the whole video. But please go check out the channels. Obviously, the links are down in the description box. Okay, so this movie is directed by Woody Allen. Ugh. Yes, in most cases, I would rather shoot myself than to watch his movies. I honestly hate Woody Allen movies. The film stars Owen Wilson as Gil, a successful Hollywood screenwriter who is visiting the capital of Paris with his over-controlling, overly nagging and annoying fiance played by the usually lovely Rachel McAdams. In most cases, I love Rachel McAdams, but in this movie, I just wanted to wring her scrawny neck. She's so self-indulgent and she just comes across as a complete bit. Gil himself is obsessed with Paris in the 1920s. He loves the music, the culture, and adores the people who lived during that era. Obviously, he would love to live in that time, but unfortunately for him, he's stuck in modern times with his annoying fiance. Her name is Inez, by the way. Her judgmental parents who don't fully approve of him, and Inez's pretentious douchebag know-it-all friend named Paul. Played brilliantly by Michael Sheen, I might add. Sound interesting? Of course not. But wait, there's a twist. Gil strolls around Paris at night, just to, you know, clear his head, get his mind off of things. But when the clock strikes midnight, an antique car rolls up, picks him up and transports him to 1920s Paris. There, he's able to meet all of his idols, including Ernest Hemingway, Scott Fitzgerald, Cole Porter, Gertrude Stein, and Pablo Picasso, just to name a few. And I really, really wanted to stay far away from this movie for two reasons. One, I honestly hate Woody Allen movies. He films everything with mono sound. Why? He's got to be the only guy to direct movies with mono sound. It's like, live in the now! Maybe he has a hearing problem, but the rest of us don't. And I honestly don't find these movies interesting. Please, if anybody knows the true reason why he records everything in mono sound, let me know. And the second reason is, the trailer nearly killed me! It's so boring! I literally wanted to shoot myself halfway through the trailer. It was just so confusing and so poorly put together. I think Woody Allen wanted to keep the whole time travel aspect a secret, but really there was no reason for it. In fact, that's the one aspect that would have intrigued the most people. Now, like I said, I really didn't want to see this movie, but after seeing that it got almost unanimous acclaim from most pretentious professional critics, as well as some of my favorite YouTube critics, first, I went into a state of shock. Then I got really interested. But the one that sealed the deal for me was Tom Chalabash. He recently reviewed this movie, and I said to myself, if he gives this movie a positive review, not only am I going to watch it, but I'm going to review it. I just hope I don't kill myself. If I do, my blood is on his hands. Well, Tom is off the hook, because obviously I'm still here. But I have to admit, I'm quite shocked. Because I actually liked a Woody Allen movie. And if you're a fan of true film, it's hard not to like this movie at least a little bit, or at least appreciate it in some way, shape, or form. The movie has great acting, great dialogue, and what I love about it is that the movie is very subtle. It's also quirky and very smart. I like how they show off the wonders of Paris without overshadowing the story or the characters. Unlike, let's say, The Tourist, where I cared more about seeing the sights of Venice than I did the bullshit plot. I really like the story. You don't know if all of this is in Gil's head or if it's real or not until the very end. And they even toy with the notion of whether it's real or not. There's even a good message during the revelation of the plot. Owen Wilson was also good in this movie. Wilson is usually an oddball, but this is a movie where his oddness kind of pays off. One of my favorite scenes involves Michael Sheen's character Paul pretentiously discussing the history of a painting done by Pablo Picasso. And Gil, Wilson's character, completely owns his ass after he calls him on his inaccuracies. Adrian Brody has a fantastic cameo as Salvador Dali. He was great, but in a small way, I kind of wish he had a bigger role. But his cameo was just perfect. Marianne Cotillard is in this movie. Most people know her from Inception. Yeah, everybody seems to forget that she won an Oscar for La Vie en Rose. Still haven't seen that movie. But she's just a wonderful actress. She plays Pablo Picasso's mistress that Gil actually falls in love with, and it's hard not to. She's just such a charming lady. The one that stole the show was Corey Stoll as Hemingway. And I honestly don't know who this actor is. I don't think anybody does. He's kind of an up-and-comer. But damn it, I'm gonna keep an eye out on this guy. He was fantastic. He gave a hell of a charismatic performance. He was funny and quite intimidating. This is just a good and relaxing film. It's not fast-paced. It may seem a bit slow at times, but it's just a very chill movie. It has an original concept, which of course is always refreshing, and it has a certain charm to it. This movie actually made me feel good. Made me feel good about life. The only negative thing I can say about this movie is that the rewatchability factor, not very high. I probably won't watch this again, but I don't know, you never know, who knows. This movie caught me off guard. I honestly wanted to be the one guy to come out and say, you know what, I hate this movie. But I can't do it, because I really did enjoy it. And because of that, and because of the film's little subtle wonders, I am gonna give Midnight in Paris 4 stars out of 5. I in all honesty cannot recommend it to anyone I personally know. They'll think I'm crazy. But if you have patience, you like good acting, good dialogue, check it out. So which era would you have liked to live in? For me, it's 2. I would have liked to have either been in the Old West, being a cowboy, riding horses, shooting guns, drawing on people, and probably dying before I reached the age of 17. Or the 1930s, during the Prohibition era, I probably would have loved to have been a bootlegger, a gangster, and dying before I reached the age of 25. Comment below, let me know, what's your fantasy era? This is Big Gabe with Stuck Burrito Entertainment, and I hope you join the Stuck Burrito Revolution by subscribing. What?